And what I want to do today is take a look first at the defense. They obviously played about as well as you could expect on Sunday with that shutout victory. And I want to point specifically to the secondary. They obviously made the moves this offseason to upgrade that unit. What the Ravens want to do this year is they want to press guys at the line of scrimmage and play an aggressive swarming style of defense. And we saw that against the Bengals. I mean, they were going up against their arch nemesis in AJ Green, and the entire game, Jimmy Smith and those other corners were basically right at the line of scrimmage. As soon as A.J. Green or any of the other receivers released off the line, the cornerbacks were right there to press them, to jam them, to make life uncomfortable for them. And that takes a toll over the course of a game. It disrupts the timing between the receivers and the quarterback. And then when you look later in the game, this is a play late in the fourth quarter, and you see Jimmy Smith here at the bottom of the screen lined up against A.J. Green. What he doesn't do, he doesn't press him here like he was earlier in the game. But you know what? It doesn't really matter, because when you've been pressing him so much throughout the entire game, the timing is already disrupted between the receiver and the quarterback. And you see here, Andy Dalton doesn't even look at the receiver. He just checks down over the middle of the field on a shorter pass route, doesn't even look to his big play receiver, A.J. Green. And I think a big part of that is the fact that the timing between them was so disrupted as a result of the way the Ravens were playing defense throughout that game. All right, so let's go ahead and flip things over to the offensive side of the ball. Obviously, when the defense is playing the way that it is, the Ravens want to pound the ball on the ground and move the clock. And that's what they did on this 18-play drive in the third quarter, where they ran the ball 12 straight times. On this third down play, it's third and four, and Buck Allen is in the backfield. He runs a nice little misdirection play where Marshall Yanda, he's the right guard, you see him pull from the right side and clear the path for him. I think this is kind of the Greg Roman effect. A little bit of a different running scheme. They changed that up this offseason, and the Ravens had a lot of success with it. And Yanda, you know, Old Faithful, he opened the hole there for Buck Allen coming out of the backfield. Now, this other play I want to point to, this is fullback Patrick Akar that gets the big block. This is only a third and one. It's not that sexy of a play. This is a two-yard gainer on third down, and the Ravens move the chains. Akar, number 42 there, seals off the hole for Terrence West to sneak through and pick up the first down. And that's what the Ravens were able to do so methodically on that drive to eat up nearly 10 minutes of clock. So obviously the Ravens would love to be able to have that much success on the ground again every single week, and also a 20-0 shutout doesn't hurt you. So that's a look at what you may miss this week.